folks, welcome back to Theory with Mr. Nick. Glad to be with you again today. Today we're going to look at time signatures. I know you often have problems with key signatures, but time signatures are pretty important too. When you think about it, you get five lines, you get a clef, treble clef, bass clef, and then you get your key signature because it's really important. It's the third thing you've got to think about. Lines, clef, key. And then comes the time signature. Before any notes appear on the page, the time signature is very important. But why do we have it and what does it mean? It looks like a strange fraction, really. 4/4 or 3/4. But it really is helpful in kind of breaking up the music in a mathematical way so that we know where the beat is, so that we can play together, and so that we can better read the music and understand where the notes fall in each measure. Well, of course, music is broken up into measures, or sometimes we call them bars. In America, mostly I think measures, but with bar lines. And in every measure, it should have the same amount of beats, unless it changes its time signature. So in 4/4 time, which is probably the most common time signature, there are 4 quarter notes. So the bottom number really represents what type of note we're talking about. So if the bottom number is a 4, then we're talking about quarter notes. If the bottom number is an 8, we're talking about eighth notes. If the bottom number is a 2, what are we talking about? That's right, half notes. If the bottom number was a 1, we'd be talking about whole notes, but that's pretty unusual. So most of the time, it's either a 4 or an 8 at the bottom. The top number represents how many notes are in that measure. So if it's 4/4, then there are 4 quarter notes. If it's 3/4, then there are 3 quarter notes. If it is 17,256 over 4, then there are 17,256 quarter notes in a measure. I don't think a piece of music has been written with that time signature so far. So that's how we read our time signature. The bottom number is the value of the note. Is it a quarter note, an eighth note, half note? And then the top number is how many are there in each measure? Time signatures that can be divided by 2 quite neatly, like a whole note divided into 2 half notes, a half note divided into 2 quarter notes, a quarter note divided into 2 eighth notes, can be called simple or common or duple time. So it's pretty simple to understand how that works. If you know your 2 times table, you should be good to go. One of them is 2/4, so that means there are 2 quarter notes in every measure. Here's an example of a march in 2/4 that perhaps you will recognize. That was the Stars and Stripes Forever March by John Philip Sousa, and that's in 2/4. Okay, and if you were to conduct that, you simply go down, up, with a little loop at the bottom. And the loop always goes out from the body, not into the body, but away from the body. So down, up, down. So the second beat is not really down, up. It's more down, up. That's where the second beat comes. If you're conducting in 2/4, it's kind of a simple pattern to conduct, very much up down, but that's how that works. And the beat in 2/4 is very much strong, weak, strong, weak, strong. Another common time signature is 3/4, where there are 3 quarter notes in every measure. And this has a nice dance quality to it, and the pulse of the music is very much strong week, week, strong week, week, strong week, week. You might hear it in a waltz, for instance. It's that time of year when the world falls in love. Every song you hear seems to say Merry Christmas, may your New Year dreams come true. And the song of mine in three-quarter time wishes you. That's called the Christmas Waltz. And there's actually a line in it that says, "And this song of mine in three-quarter time," which means three-quarter notes in a measure. This is how to conduct a 3-4. Down, away, up. And it's that same up. It's not a real triangle. The up doesn't come here. 1, 2, 3. The up comes here just like that, 2. 1, 2, 3. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Make sure you're going out from your body, not across your body. 1, out, up. 1, out, up. Down, out, up. Let's try conducting along to this song. Sometimes if 3-4 is a fast tempo song, it'll be conducted in one on a bar like this. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Otherwise you end up getting very busy. The most common time signature, at least in Western music, is 4-4. Four quarter notes in a measure. And there are thousands, maybe millions of songs in 4-4. In 4-4, the pulse is strong, weak, medium, weak. Strong, weak, medium, weak. The way to conduct 4-4 is to go down, across your body, all the way out and up. And again, that last beat coming like a little hook here on the edge. So down, across, out, up. Down, across, out, up. A nice little pattern. That's the idea. Let's have a go at conducting along to this song. There are also time signatures like 2-2. What does that mean? Well, you know that the 2 signifies half note on the bottom, and there are 2 half notes. And you might say, well, isn't that the same thing as 4 quarter notes in a measure? Doesn't it all add up to the same? Well, it does, but the pulse is slightly different in 2-2 than in 4-4. In 2-2, it's very much like 2-4. It's the same way of conducting. Down, up, down, up. And often it's in perhaps faster music where the pulse needs to be freer, a bit like this next example of Mozart's Symphony No. 40 that maybe you'll recognise. Two is often written as if it looks like 4-4, but sometimes it has the common C as the time signature with a line through it, and it means cut time. 3-2 is also a fairly common time signature, and it's just like conducting 3-4, but now you're conducting half notes. There are 3 half notes in a measure, and you might sing the hymn All Creatures of Our God and King, which is in 3-2. All creatures of our God, and 1 and 2 and 3, and 1 and 2 and 3, and 1 and 2 and 3, and 1 and 2. Please forgive my dreadful singing, But that's the idea of 3-2. And 4-2 is also used. There are four half notes in a measure. There's a great brass band piece published by the Salvation Army called Fanfare of Praise, which starts very softly in 4-4. And then begins to pick up in 4-2 as it gets really exciting. And it's a good way for the composer to write really fast notes without it looking really hard to read on the page. It's more spaced out. And what sound like 16th notes look like 8th notes on the page, and that kind of helps. And you also feel that driving pulse of the slow 4 half note, as well as all these really fast, frantic 8th notes that sound like 16th notes. Some irregular time signatures that still have a quarter note as that bottom number, like 5-4 or 7-4 or 9-4. You could have any combination, really. 5-4 is quite pleasing. You might recognize this song in 5-4. Is often strong, weak, weak, strong, weak, strong, weak, weak, strong, weak. Or it could be strong, weak, strong, weak, weak. But I think the first one is more common. The next time signatures we're going to look at are called compound time signatures, and that just means they're a little bit more complicated. And rather than being divided into twos, like the duple or the simple or the common meter, they're divided into three. So a dotted half note can be divided into two dotted quarter notes. And a dotted quarter note can be divided into three eighth notes. So that's how that's broken down, and so on and so forth with 16th notes, etc. So it's a little bit different. Think of it as a triple time, or think of those triplets against one note, da 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 di da da di da da di da da, as opposed to the duple simple time, dum dum dim dum dim dum dim dum, da 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 di da da di da da di da. It kind of lends itself to sort of a pirate theme or something flowing and majestic, perhaps. But that compound time has that sense of three rather than that sense of two. So in compound time, there's no whole notes as such. There'd be dotted whole notes and dotted half notes and dotted quarter notes. You can have quarter notes. A quarter note and an eighth note equals a dotted quarter note, and that's kind of the pulse. Usually. So you have 6-8, which is a very common compound time signature, and it's conducted in a similar way to 2-4, where it's down, up, down, up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 1, 2. If that's a fast song, it'll be conducted that way. If it's a slow song in 6-8, you would conduct all six beats, and you do it this way, down, across, across, out, out, up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Don't forget that last beat coming right here rather than up there. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here's an example of a song in 6-8 that I think you'll recognize. Christ for the world. Pulse of 6-8 is strong, weak, weak, medium, weak, weak, strong, weak, weak, medium week, week. Or if it's in a fast six where you conduct in two beats in a bar, one, two, three, four, five, six, strong, week. You have 3/8, which is very similar to 3/4, three eighth notes in a bar. And that's basically strong, weak, weak, strong, weak, weak. But often 3/8 is conducted in one in a bar. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. One, two, three. Another compound time signature is 9/8, which sounds really complicated, but that's 9 eighth notes in a measure. But it's often conducted with three dotted quarter notes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 2, 3. Or just a simple 3. 1 and 2 and 3 and 9/8, very similar to 3/4. Same deal again, 12 eighth notes in a measure, but this time you're using the 4/4 pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You would never say it out loud like that with all those numbers, but you'd simply go 1, 2, 3, 4. And those would be four dotted quarter notes in a measure, which equals 12 eighth notes. There are many irregular meters, like 5/8, which just simply means 5 eighth notes in a measure. 7/8, 7 eighth notes in a measure, kind of leaves you with one leg in the air at the end of every measure. You're expecting that eighth note in a measure, but it just pulls you back one short of that. And the same thing with 7/4, 7 quarter notes in a measure. You might recognise this piece in 7/4. I don't know if you've seen Ant-Man from the Avenger series, but that is in 7/4 and it's pretty cool. You can feel the tension and the excitement and that kind of missed beat, if you like, which just adds to the drama of the music. Well, there are more compound time signatures like 10/8, which are quite adventurous. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, dee-da-da, dee-da-da, dee-da, dee-da. Kind of gives that energy and flow to a piece of music. Or even 11/8. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. It kind of throws you off kilter a little bit, but the pulse of the music can be quite exciting. There are even some pieces in 13/8. That's 13 eighth notes in a measure. And you would conduct it 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, in a kind of 5 pattern, if you like. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. That's the idea. When guessing what meter a song is in, and it's a good thing to do when you're listening to the radio or listening to music, think, is that in 2, 4, 3, 4, 5, 4, what's it in, 6, 8? Watch out for pieces that have a pickup, or an anacrusis, is what it's called, where there's a note before the bar starts, like Amazing Grace, which is in 3/4. One, two, three, one, two, three, one. So you get the idea of the strong, weak, weak, strong. Now you would probably not sing it that fast in church, but you get the idea of how a song feels like it's in the pulse of 3 rather than 2. Okay, we're going to try some songs and see if you can guess the time signature of these next few examples. Here's the first one.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
And it burns, 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 the ring of fire. That's in a 2-4, very simple. Strong, weak, strong, weak, strong. That's the idea. Here's the next one.
Wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time.
That was a nice reminder of Christmas in one in a bar there. Here's a transmission song that you might enjoy. See if you can guess the meter and start conducting.
Send the fire, send the fire, oh Lord. Send the fire, send the fire, oh Lord.
Yeah, 6-8 is very lilting. It has a certain pulse to it, which lends itself to that type of song like Send the Fire. Here's another one. See if you can guess the time signature on this one. Now that song is Money by Pink Floyd. Here's another one. See if you can guess the time signature on this one. This time, very much a waltz like, and a little bit of Burt Bacharach, and certainly a song that I think the world needs to be singing right now. The time signature is really complicated, and even the professional musicians that were hired to record this song had a hard time figuring out where the pulse is. So it's a mixture of meters here, but predominantly in 9-8. But instead of going 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, it breaks it up into 4+3+2. 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-1-2, 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-1-2. Really complicated. This piece, I tricked you a little bit because it's in different time signatures, but uses a lot of 11-8 and 13-8, which hear in this great Beatles song how in the bridge they used mixed meters, so they're going from 6/8 to 5/8 to 4/4 to 7/8, and it kind of sort of makes it a little bit jumpy, but it, in the context of the song, it really works well, I think, where they've used different type signatures for different measures. Recognized that piece from Harry Potter. I think it was the Goblet of Fire, and it was the waltz scene where they were learning how to dance, and definitely in 3/4 that one, the waltz always in 3/4. I think you'll recognize this one.
I can hear you, but I won't.
I hope you recognise that one. It's the hit movie of this year, Frozen 2, Into the Unknown, in 12/8. So it has that four pattern, but it's definitely a compound, so it's divided into groups of three. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Has a little bit of syncopation in 12/8, so it kind of throws you off, but it's a good song. Well, I hope you've learned a little bit about meter and time signatures today. And perhaps when you're in the car or watching YouTube or listening to your music, you might ask yourself, what time signature is this piece in? And I bet you can figure it out if you can figure out the strong pulses and the weak pulses, and try conducting it through and seeing if you can figure out what's what. Thanks for listening to this episode of Theory and Ear Training, and we look forward to seeing you next time.